As I talk about this magazine, I actually talk from my heart. Wendy came to my office. They believed in me, and they thought there was an article which could come out of me. And like you've been told, I kept telling them not to. He's really let the bag out of is it the cat out of the bag or something like that? And I had no idea. You know, it's the way you just keep feeling like maybe you have a better story. And they refused to wait. So I hope, architect, you're going to feature me again now that I got to the position I wanted to be featured as. So maybe just to get it right, because like architectural was saying, when there are changes in the government, sometimes we don't get it very clearly where we are. I'm a principal secretary, not permanent. Principal secretary in the State Department of Housing and Urban Development. It's good to get it right because there are times you need the government and you need to know where to go. And you are in the Ministry of, this is the way it is, eh? You will believe me. We are in the Ministry of Transport, Infrastructure, Housing and Urban Development. So I was telling you, I speak for this company and for this magazine with passion. And so I made sure I wrote it down, because if I don't write it down, I might forget some of the issues I wanted to cover. I would wish to say all those other things we say, housing secretary and all of this, but because I want to recognize every one of you who's here, I salute every one of you, and we have government officials with us here, we have senior professionals, even my classmate. Let me identify with my classmate because I can see his photograph on one of the posters here. I was actually classmates with architect Jimmy Getoho, so I wish to recognize him. Otherwise, I may not get out of there in peace. Thank you. I also have quite a number of our members of staff, our professionals in this room. We have our director of administration, two of them, and many other professionals with us. So I recognize every one of you, and I say good evening to you all. Good evening. I must say I'm very, very delighted for the invitation this evening, and I'm greatly honored and privileged for this opportunity to make a few remarks as the family of Kenya Media Limited celebrates the 20th issue of Build Design. Someone once said, and I hope it's not any one of you here, if I quote you, you can ask me for, are they called loyalties or royalties, one of those. Happy are those who dream dreams and are ready to pay the price to make them come true. 9 years ago, a certain young man who continues to remain young had a compelling dream. And I was also going to say it's very complicated to be the last speaker, because by the time you speak, everything has been said. But what I promise you is that I'll make a very good summary of all the things that have been said. So if I sound like I'm repeating, just know it's very deliberate that I'm making a summary of what has been said. And this dream was to highlight the creative work of the professionals in the building industry in our country. This was a dream to inform the general public on how to professionally implement construction projects. And you had architect telling us all this. The founder of this magazine identified an information gap, and we've had that. I'm just confirming that's what he said, and sought to provide a solution. And that is what we professionals, including the many architects who are here, are all about. We are about providing solutions to issues in the construction industry and even beyond. And that is really a mindset each and every one of us should have here, because we actually should find solutions. We should not be people, and I'm happy even Crown Paints are here, because they keep telling us of how they have identified a gap and they have found a solution to this. So let us embrace this mindset of giving solutions. And today, indeed, we gather here to celebrate an achievement that seeks to recognize building professionals, and I'm told we'll be giving awards at the end of this. In fact, I'm trying very hard so that I can be one of the people who get awards. If I don't get, I'll forgive you. who and these are building professionals who have contributed to the Nairobi's impressive skyline and the country at large. Today's event is a clear evidence that persistence produces results, and you could tell you had architect Tyro telling us how he went on and how he tried many things. I wish to commend you, Architect Tyro, for not giving up. I know there were times the temptation to give up raised his ugly head, but you held on. Architect Tyro, I'm talking to you. You did hold on, you persisted, you persevered, and you kept on going, even when the going was tough. And you actually did share that with us a few minutes ago, that even you refused to say the ministry, but we all knew it must have been Ministry of Public Works. That was after you. Architect Tyro and your team at BuildDesign, bravo once again for this remarkable achievement. To venture into a relatively untapped area, persist in it for over 9 years, is no mean feat. It is worth all the toasting. And I want to believe there'll be a toasting even after when we are through with the speeches. Over the last two decades, Kenya has witnessed unprecedented urban growth, which has created the need for more professionals in the construction industry. And I heard the president of AAK saying that he doesn't want to talk about collapsing buildings, but we in the government have to talk about it because it's a reality, and it's a reality that we need to get solutions for. The imbalance of growth in the construction industry has resulted into unapproved and substandard buildings, which on occasion have collapsed with some fatalities and loss of property. The government has made significant strides. We need to tell you what the government is saying, because with the government you have to have hope, because there's got to be somebody who's doing something about the things that happen around us. And we are addressing all these issues that arise. And we are saying this, as a government, we need to give guidance on how issues should be handled. So various policies and legislations are in place to guide the construction industry. And we are in the final stages to realize other legislations that respond to emerging issues, including this worrying trend of buildings that have collapsed. Amongst the many actions that government has taken in addressing some of these occurrences is that His Excellency the President in January last year directed that a national audit. Please, people, you need to listen, because you need to know that there is hope. As much as sometimes you feel like things are taking every direction, there is hope because the government is in place. We got instituted an institution we call the National Inspectorate, and this National Inspectorate takes care of auditing of buildings. This National Inspectorate, headed by QS Moses Nyakiongora, in fact, he was supposed to have been here, but he was unable to come because he needed to attend to some very, very serious issue. This was formed for that task and has since audited 3,900 buildings which are in high-risk areas. So please note that the government is taking action on all these for these buildings which cause injuries to the people of this country. We also say this, and this was referred to by Engineer Akech, that low risk areas have not been spared either, as witnessed in last week's collapse of retaining wall of an ongoing project in Westlands. And this is what happened after that. The government took action, and we are saying the government has guided that constructions with foundation excavations exceeding 4.5 meters will need to have a registered structural engineer confirm that all structural considerations are in place, and to ensure safety in the implementation of the project, and also confirm the structural integrity of these developed structures. I know that statement has put me in a bit of trouble, because as we step out there, I'll be asked, like, do you want us to stop all the constructions that are going on? We are not saying that the construction should stop. What we are saying is, for you to continue, you need to have a structural engineer, a registered structural engineer, confirming that the implementation of that project will not cause any danger to the people, who are constructing, or even the people who will eventually use that building. Another major step undertaken by the government, and this was Engineer Akech actually very well represented the National Construction Authority, is the setting up of the National Construction Authority, which was set up in 2011 for the purpose of regulating and building capacity of contractors in the industry. The authority continues to contribute towards ensuring professionalism in the part of contractors in construction. I'm just about to end my long speech. Inasmuch as the government plays the key role of ensuring the safety and standard in construction, all of you professionals who are here need to stand and be counted in ensuring professionalism in the construction industry. I therefore urge you to complement the efforts of the government towards this very noble goal. Now, in closing, I wish Buildesign even greater success as you continue in this noble cause of keeping the industry vibrant, because it's true, you do keep the industry vibrant. You keep the industry alert, lively, and informed. So keep up the good work. And I wish to bless you, Buildesign, of buyers where we bless. God bless the construction industry in Kenya and beyond, and God bless Kenya.